Welcome to my channel Learning at Home. In this channel, I will provide you notes of physics as well as chemistry at your home. So, with the help of this channel, you can learn about the chapter, about basic concepts here, means that is at your home. So, for that, you have to subscribe my channel Learning at Home. So, let us start with the chemistry first chapter, that is chemical reactions and equations. So, what type of actually reactions changes take place? That is physical and chemical change. In case of physical change, the substance which we have get, that can be reversed or that can be reversed again. So, suppose we have taken a rubber band, if we stretch that and leave this, so we can get the initial state. That means it is a reversible change. So, and suppose we have taken some other substance, like we are burning a candle. So it is also a physical change. And next example, if we cut the wood into smaller pieces, that is again the same. Means it is a physical change. So let me tell you, what is chemical change? Chemical change means, suppose we have got some substance after the change, after the reaction, so that cannot be reversed again, like soaring of milk or setting of curd and rusting of iron, then ripening of fruits. These such type of changes which are chemical, which are reverse in nature, and they are called as chemical change. So, now come to chemical reaction. Chemical reaction means a new substance is formed, right? And in any chemical reaction, we have two forms. Like, suppose we have two substances A and B, and it gives substance C and D. And whatsoever substances are reacting, so these are reactants. These are reactants. And whatsoever we get, that is product. That is product. So, how the question arises, how we come to know that chemical reaction has been taken place? So, for that, we have the following observations. First one is evolution of gas. Evolution of gas means, suppose we are reacting two species and the reaction after the product we get. So along with that we will get our evolution of gas will take place. So suppose I am taking an example of sulfuric acid and zinc metal. So in this case, hydrogen gas will be evolved. Suppose this is zinc metal and second one sulfuric acid. So what we get ultimately? Zinc sulfate and this is H2. H2 gas I have shown through this arrow. This means evolution of gas is taking place. So we have then second example, if we replace H2SO4 with HCl, that is HCl means hydrochloric acid, right? So we get zinc plus HCl and zinc chloride is a product and again H2 gas is evolved. Then second one is formation of precipitate. Suppose we are reacting two species and we get some space, some substance which is solid mass and particular color, that is known as precipitate. For that we will take another example of this precipitation. So precipitation of substance, so this is first one is potassium iodide and lead nitrate, and we get lead iodide and potassium nitrate. So this is again precipitate, we get yellow precipitate of lead iodide. Then barium chloride and sulfuric acid. So we get barium sulfate as a precipitate, which will be of white, and plus HCl is as a product we get. Then change in color. Change in color means, suppose we are reacting some substances and some change in color is taking place. Suppose we mix citric acid and KMnO4. KMnO4 means potassium permanganate. If we mix that, the purple color of potassium permanganate will discharge. That means it will decolorize the color of potassium permanganate. Then fourth one is change in temperature. So let me tell you what type of, how temperature can be changed. So basically we have two types of reactions. One is exothermic reaction. Exothermic reaction. And second one is endothermic reaction. Endothermic reaction. Exothermic reaction means, in that particular example, is that reaction in which heat is evolved. Heat is evolved. In which heat is evolved. Suppose we are mixing two substances like calcium plus carbon and oxygen, right? So carbon dioxide and heat is evolved. And second example, if we mix calcium carbonate and plus water, we get carbon dioxide and in the form of heat and calcium hydroxide. So these are endothermic reaction in which heat is evolved. But in case of endothermic reaction, heat is absorbed. Heat is absorbed. Heat is absorbed. For that, suppose in we mix any two substances and temperature decreasing. That means some change or some heat is evolved, absorbed. That is endothermic reaction. For that, we can take example of ferrous sulfate plus water, and ultimately if we touch that test tube in which we have mixed these two substances, and this will if we touch that, we feel a little bit less temperature, or it will be cooling feeling like that. So this type of reaction is endothermic reaction. Change of state. Suppose we are mixing two substances and there is change in state. Like suppose initially the substances were at liquid or solid state, and the product which we get, that also change in state. Suppose liquid, instead of liquid, the second substance is gas or solid, anyone else. So for that, suppose if we burn a candle, it is a starting from burning, it is at liquid state, solid state, and after burning it may get converted into liquid state. So that means the change has been taken from solid to liquid. And the second example, burning, suppose we take zinc granules plus sulfuric acid or HCl. So zinc metal is at solid state and sulfuric acid is at liquid state, and after the reaction the substance we get, that is zinc sulfate or zinc chloride, depending upon the substance which we have taken, second one, and the evolution of gas has been taken place. So again state has been changed. So this is all about the changes of reaction, changes which we observe or which we get, which we, through that we can able to understand why, whether the chemical reaction has been taken place or not. So for the further information, you have to just subscribe my channel and comment also and share this channel to get, and further getting new notes or upcoming notes, so you have to subscribe my channel